Hello there, everybody. This is Getty92 coming at you today with a new episode of your daily dose of Rush. Except Fridays, but you guys know that. For today, we are going back in the year of 1975, Carous of Steel. And the song for today is the opening song, Bastille Day. That sounds Transylvanian to me. Bastille Day. But we will get to the song. I know it has an epic guitar intro, so let's get into it. What is that music? What is that MTV, kind of like MTV in the Cribs or something like that? This is from 1975 and it sounds like a damn song from the early 2000 years of MTV. Let's be honest, guys. And this is awesome. This is a great thing. They were 25 years ahead of their time with that song intro already. This song, I think, will capture the whole MTV, successful MTV era that we know. That's a tone of a guitar solo that you would never expect. You would never expect such a tone on a guitar solo there. down, this is a phenomenal song. Yesterday, we had the song and theme from the 1975 Fly By Night record. And today, we had from the Carous of Steel record, this great song, Bastille Day. And I was actually focusing on the lyrics, and I was kind of like confused about what the song actually is about, and then I had to Google at the same time what the Bastille Day means, and it's the French National Day. So I didn't know that. So it all makes sense now what Getty was singing in this song. This is great. This is actually the anthem that you would expect when you buy an album like Fly By Night. Damn, I'm having problems these days. And you would buy the Fly By Night record and you see the title Anthem. You would expect that a song that is called Anthem would sound like this. So this is actually, I would say, at least for me personally, that Bastille Day is part two of the French National Anthem and part one is Anthem on the Fly By Night record. I'm just throwing that into you guys, into the community. Think about that. It's not a coincidence. It's both songs are the first songs on each record. So I think there is a connection to that. Great guitar. Great weird guitar. Weird in a positive way that I said that actually in the video. That the guitar solo, when that guitar solo started, it doesn't sound like what you would even expect from the tone, the sound of the guitar. You would never expect such a great, darker, way more in the midsection based EQing style guitar there. That was really interesting. The vocal styles of Getty on this one are amazing because he's doing the usual Rush stuff, then he's singing in a rock style, and then he also adds some kind of like, I don't know how you would say it, like very classic sounding guitar. Voice, of course, very classic sounding voice there, and all mixed up in this song. And I think I can't remember when I listened to Bastille Day, because I have never heard this ending of that song where it really sounded like a damn anthem. And I've never heard that ending, at least that ending, I've never heard that one. So this was the first time listening to Bastille Day on Carous of Steel 1975. So what do you think about this song? I think there may be some mixed feelings about this song for some of you people, because maybe that classic style singing voice of Getty wasn't, I think, not for everybody, but I loved it. So therefore, thank you guys as usual for tuning in for today's episode, and see you guys very, very soon with a new Rush reaction video. Thank you and see you soon. Bye.